Donald Regan. Nice to meet you. Shall we all go out?
Take a pause one moment. Fred Ryan needs to take Sister Priscilla outside first.
I have no bone to see with Duke.
You have more than that.
Once again, you'll go to the podium. Mother Teresa's to the left of the podium. You're just to the left of Mother Teresa. We have toe markers.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. This great house receives many great visitors, but none more special, more revered than our beloved guest today. I mean that quite literally. So we rather appreciated her priorities, and we're very happy indeed that she could come to America to India. However, it simply occurred to us, and we wanted to honor her, that the goodness in some hearts transcends all borders, and she accepted. And I will now read the citation. Most of us talk about kindness and compassion, but mother to her order, or the missionaries of charity and spread throughout the world, serving the poorest of the poor. Mother Teresa is a... May I say that this is the first time I've given...
In the name and the reasons of poor people, that this gift, in spirit and in love, will penetrate the hearts of the people. For in giving it to me, you are giving it to them. And this is what happened to me. The next day it was that immediately we arranged to bring food to our people. And I can tell you the gift that has come from your people, from your country. And they have shown by giving their children to become sisters and to serve the poor throughout the world. We are now all over the world and trying to do for them. And my gratitude to your family and to you. And if you see God in each other, you will have love, peace, joy together. And works of love are works of peace. And love that brings gratitude to you. And keep the joy of loving. Love them and be good in your own family first, and that love will penetrate us right through the furthest place that no one's ever been, through to the least good to you, Jesus said. You did it to me. But a wonderful opportunity for each one of us to be 24 hours with Jesus and be doing what we are doing. As it is said, if you will send us in love of Christ for each one of us. So once more, I want to thank you for this, this beautiful gift, which
put in your hands and lead the people. Show them the way to Jesus.
Thank you.
God bless you. God bless you.
Tuesday and late Wednesday night. both before and after the press conference. What they found was support for the president's building after the press, more support for the president building after the press conference than before, and public support for the president virtually every point he made. CBS and ABC indicated from a small sample before the press conference strong public support, but the NBC support showed 62% saying we should not negotiate. 57% said we should not ask Israel to negotiate. 54% said we should not give in to the demands of hijackers, even if it meant the hostages were killed. Support for the president's handling of the situation was 52% Tuesday, that's before the press conference, 61% by Wednesday, and your job approval rating went up 6%.
Now, what can I ask you? What, I mean, I'm glued to CNN, of course, you know, glued. The fellow from Switzerland, isn't it?
Well, there's been a statement out of Switzerland that some way they have suggested themselves, remember, as a possible exchanging of the people on their territory.
It's not no truth to
me. Well, we are moving, let's say, several different directions to see which way brings the most pressure onto him. And we don't know which of these buttons will be the right one, but we're pushing all of them.
Good.
Yep. But in saying pushing buttons, that's merely an expression.
Yes.
I understand. That's not, yes, we won't say that. No, we're trying every avenue.
That would not be the expression to use.
No.
We have all of these attempts are non-lethal.
Now, what was this you were saying about today?
Well, all of a sudden we got a word that these Shiites there, Nabi Berri's people, had said that they were going to have a press opportunity, that the press, an event, and it turned out that they were setting a table there at the airport.
Oh, for sure.
My goodness, there are quarters up there an awful lot. And we want to know what's going to happen outside.
And you bring me in with Mother Teresa. That's a tough act to follow.
Well, this is a private sector initiative kind of commendation to Willard Scott for outstanding voluntary service and initiative in recognizing individual citizens, businesses, and civic organizations for their important contributions to the communities across the country. And I'm most pleased to give it to you because I've cheered every time when you see that these people get mentioned, and I know that it stimulates further voluntarism, benefiting an awful lot of people.
Thank you very much. That really is an honor, and I appreciate that.
We let these people have them.
Sure.
Chocolate.
I hope I can do some good.
Maybe the White House cookies.
The best cookies in the country. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you
very much. Thank you. Right. Thank you.
Good to see you.
You get that first?
I got it.
With the tilted forward? Doesn't mind tilt the star forward. The guy puts his hand on your back. Really great support. Got a wonderful picture from the inauguration. We remember where we were paying attention to it. And Mrs. Reagan, my wife, it's a great picture. Just terrific. Thanks again. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Hi, Mr. President. Good to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
I'd like to meet Burton Barr, the joint leader of the House of Representatives in Arizona.
No, you didn't see you. Thank you.
Well, listen, I'm even going to ask you for more.
Yes.
Now we're down to the
Jesus man. Like the Jesus name.
Okay. It's a pleasure to see you.
Susie. Stephanie.
Stephanie.
And Michael.
Michael, I got a second. Why don't we get a family picture? Why do you ask him somewhere?
I prepared to give him.
We think that you'd be a great candidate. We've got a wonderful candidate for senator. We need another part of the top of the ticket there. Carry the ticket, and everybody in Arizona tells me that you'd be the best candidate for governor.
Well, thank you. You've helped state government. And
thank you.
I've been there 20 years and hasn't enjoyed it. want to say that whatever you're doing has been the best for us.
Thank you very much. Now, these aren't bribes that I had here. They are just some souvenirs so you won't forget us. For you, Cufflinks.
Thank you. Chris, thank you.
And for you, a pin.
Oh, thank you very much.
And for the girls, charms. For you, a tie bar. That's the seal up there. I always like to point out just a little bit of history. You notice the seal up there? Where the eagle is looking? Or the olive branch? Well, now there's the original seal on the desk years before that. And the eagle is looking at the arrows. And after World War II, President Truman decided that with peace, let's have the eagle looking at the olive branch with peace instead of the arrow. So that's a newer version. You get the newer version.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. Appreciate the sound.
Well, Arizona's kind of our second home. You know.
I know that. Thank you.
Mr. President, great honor to see you again, sir. Remember,
John Barr.
At the gala, in the beginning, before that, down in Dallas.
Yes.
And you've given hope to a lot of people in the ranks of the disabled and done a great deal, and the others of you here in the advertising agency. The advertising council, I should say, and all that you're doing, I think it's wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. As you know, this is the kickoff for that campaign.
Yes.
Go national with the needs of the disabled. And so Ray's our key star in all of that, and given his time. And of course, Alan's worked hard on that with the decade of the disabled. You signed that document a while back, and so we're well into that program.
Well,
absolutely, Mr. President. We're grateful to you for kicking off the decade of disabled persons in this country, and that's provided leadership around the world. And Ray Charles here has personified the greatness of America, showing how disabled people can really participate and do more for themselves and contribute to our national life.
Thank you, sir.
Have you been informed in our Defense Department? How they have expanded in departments that are hiring them,
very closely,
hiring people with a handicap, some kind.
Wonderful.
Yes. Secretary Weinberg has set goals for the department and each of the services, and it's a model for the federal government. We'd love to see that happen in all the agencies of the government.
What you heard before is what we're trying to do.
You were one of Jane's occupations.
Mr. President, I think you can have it.
They have found that people are better in checking the blades for rotors in the engines.
Yeah, because it's a tax. Yeah, that's right.
Sure. And that's amazing.
They have
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you,
Secretary
Tax
Bill,
today.
Hmm?
Am I
off
your
Secretary
Tax Bill today?
You can. I'll take all the help I can get.
Good to see you.
Sorry
about
that.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
Fine.
Well,
I appreciate it.
Listen, I'm reading from the other moment. Talking yesterday.
Well, for heaven's sakes.
Yeah. Well, it took feeling too well when you said to him.
No, I know. He just wrote me the other day that he's lost about 25 pounds.
I saw him. No, I was trying to get him off the floor. That's all.
I work for you in Canada, so no,
well,
I think
thank you, sir, so much. I appreciate you having me.
Take care, Mr. President.
All right.
I've put a lot of people on this building.
Believe me, I'm feeling for them.
I didn't know they took off.
Yeah, I remember. Thank you.
It's been wonderful again.
Well,
good to see you. I just saw you chatting with an old friend of mine, Governor Schaefer.
Yes, he was in
right. Charles. I was covering governor's conferences when he was there. Covered your first
campaign, your first governor's conference, and three presidential campaigns, but I don't miss it.
You don't miss it. Now you're retired.
Now that I'm retired.
So you won't forget it.
Oh,
it's cut things. And
that's
and your wife would be here, but you would anyway. That's
no, I'm sorry. There was a little confusion as to whether she would love to.
Oh.
I'm sorry. Sorry if it was a mix-up.
Well, yeah. No, we just miss seeing her, but give her the pin.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. And I wish you the best.
Well, thank you.
It's a tough job. And we in the press sometimes are a little hard on you. We're patriotic when we do it, Mr. President.
Okay.